The Philippine Central Bank and the Bankers Association of the Philippines also teaming up to strengthen the capital market. The two players are eyeing to create a reliable overnight reference rate in a bid to enhance the peso interest rate swaps market. 15 major banks have committed to quote prices for swaps. The BSP and BAP also expanding the government securities repo market to increase trading and provide an alternative benchmark for short-term loan rates. These initiatives are geared at improving loan pricing, deepening market liquidity, and supporting risk management tools for local banks.
Philippine inflation expected to ease for a second straight month in September. The BSP projects headline inflation to settle within the range of 2 to 2.8% for the month. If the forecast holds, that would be slower than August's 3.3% and would be at the lower end of the government's full-year target. The BSP says negative base effects, along with lower prices of food and oil, as well as the peso's appreciation, are the primary sources of the expected slower inflation.
Britain becomes the first G7 country to end coal-fired power production as it closes its last coal plant after 140 years Monday. The UK announced plans to shut down coal plants in 2015 as part of wider measures to reach its climate targets. In April, the G7 major industrialized countries agreed to scrap coal power in the first half of the next decade. Coal power still makes up more than 25% of Germany's electricity and more than 30% of Japan's power. Emissions from energy make up around three-quarters of total greenhouse gas emissions, and scientists have said that the use of fossil fuels must be curbed to meet goals set under the Paris Climate Agreement.
Also closing down Britain's biggest steel mill, the last blast furnace at Port Talbot in Wales is shutting down Monday after 100 years, with nearly 3,000 jobs going with it. Once the largest steelworks in Europe, its closure marks a culmination of decades of decline in Britain's steel industry, which has struggled to compete with low-cost imports. The British government has said it wants to invest £2.5 billion in the steel industry. It is set to publish its plans next year.
An analyst sees better times ahead for the Israeli economy if it cuts back on its war spending by next year. That statement comes in the wake of a steep credit rating downgrade by Moody's from A2 to Baa1. Moody's also maintained a negative outlook on Israel's economy amid the recent escalation of its conflict with Lebanese armed group Hezbollah. The downgrade kept Israel's rating, its lowest in 25 years, three notches into investment grade. But this analyst sees hope on the horizon.
I see it stabilized. I see it better a year from now. I think that the cost of war, if not going on, not expanding into other areas like Iran, if we can limit the war to South Lebanon and to limit their ground operation, I think the situation will relatively rapid stabilize and be better. And then we'll see the risk of the economy going down, and the ability to invest more in the economy, reinvest, and the climate of doing business in Israel will improve, I think, in the short term. And in 5 years, definitely much better than now.
The capsule sent to bring home two astronauts stranded in space has arrived at the International Space Station. The SpaceX Dragon capsule, manned by a NASA astronaut and a Russian cosmonaut, docked at the ISS Sunday. They will bring home astronauts Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams in February next year. Wilmore and Williams went to space in June for what was meant to be an eight-day mission. It has turned into an eight-month ordeal after the Boeing Starliner capsule they used was deemed unfit to transport them back to Earth. Dragon.